a difficult and challenging subject to talk about. What was before the creation of our universe? Everything we know about this extremely difficult question is based on theories. Humans still have no idea what happened before the singularity that formed our universe. If you are interested in how the Big Bang happened, feel free to watch part 1 before watching part 2. At some point on planet Earth, life came into existence. Was it the perfect condition, or a standard process happening all over the universe? It had to come out of something. We know that the Big Bang created important building blocks for human life, planets, stars, and galaxies to exist. But how do we know what is the absolute starting point of everything? How do we know our universe is everything, or just a part of something else? And how could it have been created from nothing? Scientists might have the short answer. Some believe before the Big Bang, there was literally nothing. Since the singularity of the Big Bang was infinite, we now know this creates the absence of time and space. There was no time, meaning that there is nothing before it. So are we comprised of an infinite dense point in which there is no history because time couldn't exist? A difficult answer to understand and accept, but a highly accepted one in the science community. Maybe we need to understand that this question is something we as humans will never be able to understand. We quote Einstein, "Answering the question, what was before the Big Bang, is like answering what is more north than the North Pole." Let's go back to what might have been before the Big Bang. The next theory suggests that a universe had a massive collision with another universe. This created the Big Bang and formed our universe. This event is happening all the time, but this again creates the question, what created the first universe? Well, maybe we need to go back to a black hole, an event in which all matters fall into. If you put this in perspective, a black hole could be the back of a Big Bang. Matter falls into the black hole. It gets stuck inside this infinite dense point and comes out the other side, creating a new universe. Maybe the back of the black hole was a white hole. This could be happening all the time, everywhere in our universe. We simply don't know what happens after a black hole. As we theorize about the different possibilities that answer the question, what was before the Big Bang, we now know it's a much more complicated one than we think, since we are limited by our own capacity to understand the answer to this question. We don't even know what is the question we need to ask. We continue our research. Stephen Hawking thought it's an answer we are simply not able to understand or able to accept. There is just nothing before the Big Bang. Our human perception, which is governed by time, is simply not able to understand that something cannot be there. A good example is we are in desperate search of dark matter. This matter takes up roughly 80% of our universe. Yet we know something is there, but we can't figure out what it is. We are always in search of answering the question why things are. Maybe this question is just too much for us to understand. It can always be more frightening when we are talking about our universe. Maybe our universe has a different starting and end point. We are talking about the ultimate fate of the universe. It's named this way because it's like the circle of life. It answers our fate and starting point. We call this the Big Bounce. Some cosmologists refer to it as the Big Crunch. It means that at some point, our universe becomes so big, everything will become unstable and start to collapse on itself. The creation is reversed, and we are being crushed back into an infinite dense point in which time doesn't exist, and our universe is reborn again. Imagine standing on Earth and you see the stars come closer, the sun approaching, and galaxies visible in the night sky, to ultimately being consumed by the enormous space that's being crushed together by gravity. force that will wipe our universe and create a new one from nothing. What if behind a black hole is a white hole that is reversing the destruction of the singularity of a black hole? A white hole is a hypothetical region in space-time which nothing can enter, but matter and light can escape from it. What if the white hole is spewing the mass and matter of blackness into a new or other universe? If you fly close to a white hole, would you be pushed away by its massive energy release? White holes could be the solution to the laws of general relativity, meaning if a black hole exists, a white hole should also exist. Even though there is no evidence of white holes, the idea seems to make sense. Maybe there are other universes among us, and we are living in a parallel universe, and the white holes are the gate to enter, and we are in the right universe for life to exist. We encourage you to look up the multiverse and pocket universes to learn more about this theory. The subject is simply too big for this video. We end this episode with a scary fact. Either there was something and we are destined to want to find out, but it will likely never happen, or there was nothing and we are not able to understand this concept. Nothing might just be nothing. Thank you for watching. We have given you a small look into this subject. We might have missed something. We might have gotten something wrong. Let us know what your thoughts are. We hope you stay around for another episode. Only if you like this video, please subscribe to see more episodes.